Hello everybody, today I'm going to teach you how to do this L bracket for less than 10 bucks. While the most of the L brackets on internet can cost more than 100, there's another problem. All of them have the archetype connection instead of their simple ones. What it means, I will need to change all my tripod because this model can change just its head. With this L bracket, I was able to take this shot without being afraid the camera would fall out or receive stress damage on its mounting system. As you can see, I set my camera what would be the wrong position. But that gives me two major advantages. First, I have open access to my external shooter release. And second, how these areas go further to the front, I have a much better grip for the camera. As you can see, I'm not working hard, I'm working smart. So, I'm not putting a lot of stress in the L bracket. It's almost in equilibrium with the camera. You can use your existing plate and set here. You just would need a longer screw, and then you would screw in your camera, and you could change easily the orientation of the L bracket. There's a list of the materials and a link to the drawings in the description down below. I'm using the most of time inches because how the wood and the quickly release are measured. But if you follow the subtitles in English or Portuguese that I made myself, you can see all the conversions on it. So, first of all, I mark 3.5 by 4 inches for cutting the base. The next step is to do the quick release plates. I made these two models. The only difference, this one is tilted all the four sides and this is not. The size of them will depend greatly on the mounting system of your tripod. Just make sure the fibers of the wood are aligned with the pointing direction you're going to use the most, because it becomes much stronger like that. I marked here 11/16 of an inch in both sides. I'm going to take that part off for half space for the blade of the jigsaw when I'm reducing here to 11/32 of an inch. In fact, I cut a little bit bigger for reduce to the height size while sanding. I just cut here. It's with 13/32, so I need to take 1/16 off, and I'm going to do that sanding. These lines is to make those angles, and for that I can use a chisel or I can tilt my jigsaw for almost 30 degrees. I just finished this piece. Be sure it's on the level when you're testing and reducing its size. I use this little piece of wood here to let it rise a little bit, because when it's glued to the base will sit on that part of the tripod. So, if this is a little bit shorter and is barely entering the tripod, when you're glued to the base, it will not fit anymore. Be sure of that. I also made this piece, as I said, you don't need to tilt this both sides, they can be straight. This one is almost on the level, there's just a little bit of space here for that, so it's okay. And I'm going to use that because it fits better. I'm going to glue the quick release to the base. This side has 1/2 inch and here almost 3/8. The next step is to attach the plate to the base of the L bracket. For that, I'm using some glue and 2 small screws just in case. I'm using 3.5 by 20 millimeters. I drilled the holes through the plate and a little bit of the base. Now, I'm going to use a countersink because the head of the screws needs to be on level with the plate. If you don't have a countersink, you can use just a bigger bit. done. Now I'm going to do the lateral piece. For that, I mark 3.5 inches in the bottom, 2 1/8 on the top, by 4 1/4 long. But before I cut, I'm also mark the back support here, and I'm going to drill the holes here. These sizes are in the drawings and will depend on the size of your camera. I'm using a 7mm drill bit, it's around 9/32, and that's it. I'm going to try to drill one more hole between the two. Now, just use a file. On both sides. Here, 1/2 inch. Now here, 1/4. We need 3 inches. And we have our back support. For connecting the lateral piece to the base, I'm using 2 screws. 4.5 by 6mm long. Just take care to not set them too much on the front, if not they will pass for the lateral piece. I drill 2 holes with a 4mm drill bit. Now I just drew a little bit more here. And now the color sink. For inserting the screws, I will start by hand, because I think it is easier. When the screws start to pass to the other side, you can set them, the base with the lateral piece. Now I'm gluing this back support to the base. For that, let me just use some glue. I just clamped here after gluing. If you don't have a clamp, just put some heavy weight. Now, from the front support, the easiest way is to draw your camera's profile in a paper. Like that. Then, draw a line with the back of your camera, plus one line 90 degrees with that. You can use the marks of your ruler to do that. Just align any of those until it matches with the bottle. Now I can set this part over the board. Now that I cut these two pieces, I'm setting my camera. See if the hole that holds your camera is aligned with that. I need a little bit of space here for the felt. And I'm going just to push these pieces. Just to have an idea where I have to hold them. Now just hold for a few minutes. For the finish, I'm using some varnish, but you can also paint or use some finishing oils. After the piece is sanded, you need to clean it with a piece of fabric, then put some solvent in the fabric and clean it really good. When you're by your finish, they can tell what kind of solvent you're going to use. But anyone for cleaning is fine. Now, for varnish, I'm going to use around 30% of solvent. Just mix well and apply it. Now that the first layer of varnish has dried, I'm going to sand it with a 320 grit. Now I'm going to clean it. Before the next layer, I'm going to glue the felt here and here. I just need to cut a little piece here. And then later I can trim the right size. Now that I have both pieces of felt, I'm going to glue here. I'm using wood glue, but you can use the normal white glue as well. And I'm also using a plastic card, like a credit card. Now you can use the card to spread. Just don't press that much to not clean the wood, the glue. Now that the glue has dried for around 10 minutes, we're going to glue this piece of felt. You can use a clean part of the card to press gently the felt against the wood. Just a small pressure. While the felt is drying, we're going to pass the second layer of varnish. Now, I'm using just around 10% of solvent. In Brazil, we call that água rasa, but probably is exactly the same thing as white or mineral spirit, or can change the name accordingly where in the world you are. For a better look, you should pass the brush in one single stroke, like that.
Now I will let it dry for around 1 day, and then I will trim the rest of the felt, and it's ready.
Before you go, I'd like to say thank you for watching. If you like, please give a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel for future projects. Also, check out my last video. Thanks again. See you next time.